So scanning electron microscope, this is the full form of same. Okay, scanning electron microscope, and again you go by the name itself. When I say same, that means scan, you have to scan the surface. Okay, scan the surface of the material and through this electron beam. So that's why we are saying as a scanning electron microscope, and it's a powerful tool basically. So whenever we see this microscope word basically, so immediately in our mind it is very clear that we are something, we are magnifying the image of particular object for better clarity. And optical microscope, you are familiar with that. Now this time we are going to use electron microscope. Okay, so keep in mind electron microscopes are of two type. One is the same and another is tame. So, and the only difference if you compare with electron microscope to the optical microscope is, in the optical microscope we are using the light beam, in the electron microscope we are using the electron beam, okay, to magnify the image of a particular object. So that is the main difference between the normal microscope and the scanning electron microscope. And look at here what we get it. So with this same device, again you see these are the things we are getting, okay, the high quality image. So whenever we say high quality, that means we are talking in terms of the quality, resolution quality basically. And important thing is 3D image. Okay, so this 3D image we are getting with this same image. But at the same time, if I give you the example of TEM device, TEM, for TEM device we are getting the 2D images. So this is the main difference one can consider. Same will give you the image in 3D, but TEM device will give you the image in 2D. Okay, but both will be the high quality images, no doubt. And with these images, one can get the topographical, morphological, or the compositional information. So basically, all these word, technical word you see, topographical or morphological, basically these are related with the surface related phenomena. So surface related, all such parameters, all such details, okay, one can find out with the help of same devices. Okay, and that particular details may be applicable in various science and industry applications, where suppose if you are manufacturing a chip, okay, and on that particular chip there are so many things are I mean so many circuits you are going to paste it. Okay, so sometimes if you want to check it out whether the circuit components have been properly attached or not, so then you cannot see it with the naked eye directly. So you require the instrument like this, which can be very helpful to find out, okay, yes, that circuit arrangement or the components arrangements are proper on that. So people are using for that also. Then come to the next. Yeah, as I said, topographical, morphological, all are related to the surface related parameters. Okay, so you just search it about, or let me, I think I have covered it also on the next slide. I don't know something that's okay. So here is the topography you see. Okay, is the study of shape and features of the surface of the object. So ye topography mein kisko bolunga, yahan pe likha hai maine. Someone was asking about this. Morphology is basically a branch of science. Okay, jaise maine acoustic ke case mein kiya tha. So morphology is a branch of science dealing with this structure of object and their specific structural features. Okay, so is sari study jo hogi, it comes under morphology. Or topography is basically this, as I said, the feature of the surface of this object we are knowing as a topography thing. Then come to the history part. Okay, so the scientist, let me try to annotate if possible. Yeah, so the scientist is Charles Ortlieb and their assistants, they created this device, same device in 1950s you see. Okay, and here I have described the same feature. This electron microscope utilizes the basic principle as light microscope only, but its important thing is this uses the energetic electron beam compared to the photons. Whenever I see photons, that means it is a visible light. Okay, and the purpose you see, the purpose of microscope is to magnify the object image. Okay, so that's what we are going to use this. Then components wise, so here is a component or a structure you see on the right hand side part. Okay, so now this part I'm leaving for you people to go through in more detail. Okay, because we have limited time, I will not discuss each and every part, but I will give you some idea. So here is the electron gun, or basically the electron source from which you are incidenting the electron beam. Then you are using different anodes to control the electron beams. Okay, and here it is anode, then magnetic lenses so that you can guide this electron beam. in a particular alignment, and then you see there are so many scanning coils maybe there, and different kind of detectors are also there. So here it is the backscattered electron detector, then secondary electron detectors, fine. And here is the specimen, this much. ये जो आपको दिख रहा है इस particular plate पे, okay, इस plate पे, this is the specimen over here. So the purpose over here is, the important thing I will highlight from this figure is, the specimen or the material, okay, to for which you want to see the image, that material you have to keep at the bottom side. वो आपको bottom में रखना है, because the purpose is you need to incident the electron beam and you need to scan the surface of the material. Remember, you don't want to penetrate the material, you just want to scan the surface of the material, okay? And that is why we are keeping the material at the bottom. But when the same structure we are having in the case of TEM also, but in the case of TEM, the full form of TEM is transmission electron microscope. That means you need to transmit the electron beam through the surface of the material, and for that we are keeping in the center. But in the case of SAM, we just need to scan the surface, outer surface. So that's why we are keeping down, okay, keeping at the bottom of the this device. So yahan pe dikh raha hai aapko place specimen, okay? So for more such components, इलेक्ट्रॉन गन क्या है, मैग्नेटिक लेंस कैसे काम में आता है, सेकेंडरी इलेक्ट्रॉन डिटेक्टर्स क्या होते हैं, बैकस्कैटर्ड क्या होता है, इज ऑल फिनोमिना यू कैन फाइंड इट आउट इन योर ओन एंड कम टू दिस. एज आई सेड, ये तो आपके लिए टास्क है. सेम इमेजिंग प्रोसेस इज ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर. इफ यू आर क्लियर विद द डायग्राम, लेट मी टेल यू वन मोर टाइम. दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम यू हैव टू स्ट्राइक फ्रॉम दिस साइड, ओके, देन इट हैज टू पास थ्रू सेवरल कॉइल्स, ओके, फोकस होगा बीम आपका, फोकस करवा के आपको कहाँ पे टारगेट करवाना है, ऑन दिस स्पेसिमन अप टू हेयर, ओके. सो सेम थिंग दे हैव रिटन ओवर देयर इन द प्रोसेस, तो वो आप अपनी वर्डिंग्स पे लिख सकते हो. यहाँ पर मैं एक बार थोड़ा सा गो थ्रू कर देता हूँ फास्ट. ये इलेक्ट्रॉन गन जनरेटिंग ए बीम, देन यू सी लेंसेस आर ट्यूब्स, देन क्वाइल्स आर एडजस्टेड टू फोकस द इंसिडेंट इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम, ओके, ऑन द सेम पल्स, एंड ऑफकोर्स एट द लास्ट via the computer you can note it down the particular counts which is coming out from different detectors, okay, and that counts will be important to determine the surface area which need to be scanned. So ye sari cheeze will be clear for this. Then come to the next one, okay, ye wahi cheez hai kaise kaam karta hai, so I will skip this. Process summary again, you can, if you want, you can go through that. A scanning electron microscope provides the detailed surface data, as I said, and you see this incident electron beams, focus on them. I mean, all such things are there same way as I described again. And important is this one. So this same produces black and white, but 3D images. Keep in mind, okay? Same produces black and white and 3D images. So ये आपको खास ध्यान रखना है. And here is the image. So can you identify? Can you identify this, whether it is in 2D or 3D?
3D, sir.
Yes, so it is in 3D, and if you want more such images, then directly you can search on the Google same images. So there you can see the variety of images, different, because these all such images are depend on the type of material which you are selecting. Okay, so sometimes you may see this kind of structure, sometimes you may see this kind of structure also, but that has to be the 3D format only. Advantages, okay, of course there are so many advantages, wide array of applications, as I said, and you can get the 3D images. Important is this one. Second, easy to operate, but with proper training. So someone has to train for running this setup, and then it works very fast, within few minutes, okay, within 5 minutes to 10 minutes, one particular image you will get, okay. So it's very fast compared to any other devices, and of course you need to prepare little bit preparation you need to do for before placing the sample, okay. So yeah, minimal hi aapko banana padega. It means you cannot put directly that particular material inside this same device, so little bit preparation you have to do that, and then only you can place it inside this. So these are the advantages we are having, but at the same time few disadvantages may also be there. So let's look at what are the disadvantages. So generally it is very costly, no doubt it is expensive, but it is very large and must be housed in a separate place, okay, separate area where it is free from any possible electrical or magnetic interference. So that is very important, and that's why we required a completely isolated place. And second, it involves the maintenance, okay, keeping a steady voltage you required continuously, okay, and of course cool water का भी requirement है आपका. थर्ड थिंग, ट्रेनिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड टू ऑपरेट ए सेम डिवाइस, ओके, और एज वेल एज फॉर प्रिपेयरिंग द सैंपल्स ऑल्सो. सो इट इज नॉट लाइक ए रेंडम पर्सन कैन गो एंड प्रिपेयर द सैंपल एंड पुट इन साइड द सेम डिवाइस एंड ऑपरेट. सो वन हैज टू बी प्रॉपरली ट्रेन फॉर दिस एक्टिविटी. द फोर्थ वन, यू सी, दिस इज लिमिटेड ओनली फॉर द सॉलिड मटेरियल, सॉलिड इनऑर्गेनिक, और एंड दैट कैन ऑल्सो फिट इन साइड द वैक्यूम चेम्बर, ओके. प्लस इट ऑल्सो हैव टू हैंडल मॉडरेट वैक्यूम प्रेशर ऑल्सो. सो फॉर ऑल ओनली सच ऑफ मटेरियल्स इट कैन बी यूजफुल, ओके, इट कैन बी एप्लीकेबल. अनदर वन इज दिस कैरीज अ स्मॉल रिस्क ऑल्सो बिकॉज दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम्स, ओके, दे आर समटाइम्स हार्मफुल ऑल्सो. सो इफ दे आर गोइंग टू कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द पर्टिकुलर डिवाइस, देन द पर्सन हु इज ऑपरेटिंग द डिवाइस मे गेट सम एडवर्स इफेक्ट ऑल्सो. Okay, so that is why one has to be very careful while dealing with such kind of sophisticated instrument. Applications, as I said, there are various. Industry side में जाओगे और wherever you go, and you see, as I said again, here you see the line, assembly of microchips for the computers. So various things are there, even in the semiconductor inspection. Okay, or whichever way you think, if you want to see the image at the nano scale or up to the micro scale to nano scale, then one can go for the same images, same devices. Okay, so life science, I mean all such basic sciences, jitne bhi hai, biology hoga or something medical, forensic science. So these, even metallurgy also, you see. So all these are very, very important. Yeah, reference hai. If you want, you can note it down, this particular reference. So where all the details which I have discussed till now, okay, you can find out on this site. I have taken the content from this particular site only. So you can go through that to directly find all the contents. Then coming to the second devices, that is transmission electron microscope, or sometimes people are calling it as a TEM also. You see this? Yes, so I will paste it down. Just a minute. No, it seems it is not working from here. Let me check it out. Okay. So I have given the link for the same. Then coming to the transmission electron microscope. So again, it is working on the same principle. It is also giving you the same kind of data, but there is a few difference. So here you see, same thing, surface related parameters only you will get it. Again, electron beams. So okay, so and then you see important is this one, this part. Let me highlight one more time. Okay, this one. So the maximum magnification you will get it, that is of 1 nanometer. That means it can sense the particular size or particular image up to the 1 nanometer level. Okay, so that is very important. And the same thing we have discussed from the diagram also, that this device can give you the accurate data for the particles which are up to nano level also. Okay, it's very powerful. Again, it will produce the high resolution image, but it is 2D only. Remember, same gives you the 3D images. This will give you the 2D images. Okay, and again, the applications part, you see, it may be at the educational institute also, science, industry, various places you can find it out. If you are interested, particularly going into the nano level scale, then you must go for the TEM devices. Okay. Little bit history and background for this also, we can check it out. So here is the scientist, Ernest Ruska. He developed this first TEM devices. Look at here. In 1931, he developed this along with this Max Knoll. And here it is again. It also works on the same principle like optical microscope. The only difference you see, I have listed down over here. This is very important. So this electrons replaces photons. Okay. Electromagnetic lens replaces the glass lenses which we have in the optical microscope, and images
we are in the microscope, normal microscope, we are through, seeing through the eyepiece, but now the images we are seeing on the screen. Okay, so that these are the main difference between the normal microscope and the electron microscope one can have. Then come to this device structure. Okay, so here again, this the diagram will be there. Keep in mind, if in exam it is coming like this, then don't need to prepare as it is structure, but you can create a block diagram and put the important components like high voltage, electron gun is where. So this is your electron gun. Okay, then again that same condenser lens. Okay, and different things, electron beams are there, something. So keep in mind all such things. Okay, just wait a minute. Okay, and here you see the important part which I want to discuss with you people, that somewhere at this point you see here it is. Okay, we are keeping the sample. So as I said, the purpose is we need to transmit the electron beam through the surface of the material, and that is why we are keeping at the center in the same device. Again, there is a one more diagram. Let's look it out that also. Here it is. So you see electron gun lenses, a specimen grid, that means on which you have to keep your sample here. And then again, there are few different lenses we are using so that we can align the electron beam. And finally, from this side, we can note it down the image, we can find out the image, and we can analyze further. And at the same side, यहाँ पे अगर मैं इसको ये दिख रहा है आपको राइट हैंड साइड में, सो यू कैन इजीली आइडेंटिफाई दिस इज द 2D इमेजेस, राइट? कंपेयर टू अर्लियर केस, वी हैव सीन द 3D इमेजेस. Now with the help of TEM, we are seeing the 2D images, which is very clear from this picture itself. Important thing, again, I'm repeating, this material which you have to place it, okay? So in the TEM, you have to keep in center, but in the case of SAM, you need to keep at the bottom side. This is again activity for you people to find out the each component and how it's working. It's working is almost similar to the same device only, just a slight difference. तो वो मैंने आपको बताई दिया, अदरवाइज सेम है. सो आई विल स्किप इट डाउन, बट इन अनदर पॉइंट व्हिच यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड व्हाइल डीलिंग विद द टेम डिवाइसेस इज दिस. ओके, लुक एट दिस. सो ड्यूरिंग द ट्रांसमिशन द स्पीड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स डायरेक्टली कोरिलेट्स विद द इलेक्ट्रॉन वेवलेंथ. ओके, सो जितना फास्ट आपका इलेक्ट्रॉन मूव करेगा उतनी उसकी वेवलेंथ कम होगी एंड ग्रेटर उसकी क्वालिटी होगी, उसकी क्वालिटी में उतना ही ज्यादा आएगा एंड ऑफ कोर्स यू विल गेट द गुड क्वालिटी इमेजेस. सो दैट मींस यू नीड टू मूव योर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फास्टर. ओके, so that you can get the quality images with the TEM device. Another thing is that this particular red color line you see, the lighter areas is your electron beam is transmitting. Okay, it is transmitting through the surface of the material. So that means at the end when you see the image, okay, and if you see the lighter areas of the image, that means your number of electrons are able to pass through the sample. And if you see the darker areas on the image, final outcome on the image, if you see the dark areas, that means your electron beam is not able to penetrate the sample. Are you getting that? It's very simple. There is a material, if electron beam is passing out through the surface of that material, तो आपको image lighter area मिलेगी image. But if your electron beam is not able to pass through the sample material, if it is blocking over there, then you see the dark image or darker spot on the image. क्योंकि इमेज वो जो लाइट है आपका जो इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम है दैट इज नॉट एबल टू ट्रांसमिट, वो ट्रांसमिट नहीं होगा बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. एट द अदर एंड एट द डिटेक्टर वी आर नॉट गेटिंग एनी सिग्नल, और सिग्नल नहीं मिल रहा है, दैट इज व्हाई वी आर सीइंग द डार्कर स्पॉट्स, डार्कर एरियाज कंपेयर टू द लाइटर एरियाज. लाइटर मिल रहा है दैट मीन्स योर इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम इज पासिंग थ्रू द मटेरियल, डार्कर मीन्स दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम इज नॉट एबल टू पेनिट्रेट, नॉट एबल टू ट्रांसमिट द मटेरियल. कीप इन माइंड दिस वन. ओके, सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट पीपल आर गेटिंग द आइडिया दैट यस your TEM devices is or your sample is working fine or not. Okay, so yeah, these differences, lighter areas, darker areas, that can give you the details regarding the structure, texture, size, shape, everything you will get it corresponding to that sample. So this makes very important, okay, to understand the full feature of a particular material. Arrangements, all such things are there, but let me go through that one by one. You need to, you see this, to obtain a TEM analysis, okay, sample must have certain properties. Okay, what are the properties? So they need to be sliced thin enough for the electrons. So since as I said, we need to transmit the electron beam through the material surface. So that material has to be in very thin format, okay? Slice के फॉर्म में होना चाहिए, so that your electron beams may be able to pass out through that. But अगर आपने बहुत thickness ज्यादा रखा electron beam उस material का, then your electron beam will not pass it out. और अगर electron beam pass नहीं होंगे, transmit ही नहीं होंगे, then this device is useless. कोई मतलब ही नहीं है उसका, क्योंकि आपको सिग्नल मिलने ही नहीं वाला if you are not getting the signal at the other side. Okay? So this property is also known as sometimes electron transparency. But this will be useful only when you have a very thin size of that particular material. Another is this one. Sample needs to be able to withstand the vacuum chamber. That means it has to be self-standing in mode. And sometimes you require the special preparation before viewing it. So compared to the same devices, this may take little bit time to prepare the samples. So these are the things you have to do for taking the TEM images. Okay, and again there are few other things वो भी है यहाँ पर, but we'll not discuss it. Let me come to the next slide. Advantages again you see over here, very simple, most powerful as I said, over 1 million times. Okay, so this much powerful you have, 1 million time resolution you will get it. And applications of course scientific होगा, educational में भी होगा, industry side में भी है, that is fine. And all such things you see, element and their compound structure, you will get it out. High quality images, you will get it. Okay, surface features, all the surface parameters, you will get it down. And again, it is easy to operate provided you have proper training to operate such devices. Then disadvantage, it's very large. Okay, it takes a lot of volume basically, very expensive also, of course. You need to prepare the sample, so that may take little bit time compared to the same devices. And you see, operation and training you have to provide to the person who is operating that. And important is this one. You need to create a sample which has to be very thin so that the electron beam can pass it out. Okay, so this making this thin film is very, very challenging. Okay, so here is the thing where you spend most of the time to prepare the sample. Another is this special housing and the maintenance, as I said, ki isolated hona chahiye completely from this electric and magnetic interference. So you have to keep in mind. And of course, the last one is this images, which we are getting from this. It is black and white. So black and white images we are getting in both SAM and TEM also. The only difference, main difference you consider as a 3D and 2D. Okay, SAM will give you the 3D images, TEM will give you the 2D images. ओके, ये वही चीज है, तो मैं ये सब हटा देता हूँ. एप्लीकेशंस भी ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर ही है, देयर इज नथिंग टू वरी विद दैट. समरी भी वही है कैसे काम करता है, एंड दिस इज द रेफरेंस पॉइंट. ओके, तो मैं आपको ये प्रोवाइड कर देता हूँ रेफरेंस अगेन वन मोर टाइम फॉर दिस ऑल्सो. सो यू कैन गो थ्रू विद दैट एंड यू विल सी ऑल सच डिटेल्स कोरस्पॉन्डिंग टू दिस. And now there is a slight content we have left for this XRD side also. So little bit fast, let me complete it down also XRD. So in the X-ray method, yes, I will cover it up everything. So in this method, if you see, okay, single crystal method. If you remember in the last to last lecture, we have discussed about the XRD, X-ray diffraction. And during the time we have seen that I may have told you that there are three methods under the XRD techniques basically. So the first method is single crystal method, which you see right now on the screen. So again, it's very clear there is only one crystal. Okay, and for crystal you need to find out the XRD data. So look at the arrangement basically, that is more important. Okay, so here is the X-ray source. Okay, emitting the X-ray light which are going like this. Just wait a minute. Okay, so here is the X-ray source. Okay, emitting the X-ray light, X-ray beam, and there are slits so that you can control this X-ray beam. Okay, aperture basically. And here is this mounting table. ये जो rotate दिख रहा है आपका, this is your table, round table you have. On the top of that, you are placing a crystal, single crystal, जैसे नाम में लिखा है. So that single crystal we are placing on this, ये जो दिख रहा है आपको like this. And somewhere away from this round table, we are keeping the detector. So detector को मैंने इस टाइप से रिप्रेजेंट किया बना के, बट दिस डिटेक्टर कैन बी मूवेबल. ओके, रिमूव कर सकता है किधर भी, एंड द पर्पस इज यू नीड टू डिटेक्ट द सिग्नल, सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू कैन वेरी द डिटेक्टर एंड डिटेक्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर सिग्नल. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस एक्चुअली इज दिस एक्सरे बीम यू आर गोइंग टू इंसिडेंट ओके ऑन दिस सिंगल क्रिस्टल, सो आफ्टर डिफ्रेक्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस क्रिस्टल, एंड वाई इट इज डिफ्रेक्टिंग बिकॉज दिस वेवलेंथ ऑफ दिस एक्सरेज एंड द साइज ऑफ दिस क्रिस्टल ओके बोथ आर मैचिंग, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ओनली यू आर सीइंग दैट एक्सरे बीम्स आर गोइंग टू बी डिफ्रेक्टेड. सो आफ्टर डिफ्रेक्टिंग इन दिस ऑर्डर इट विल मेक सम एंगल ओके, इट विल डिफ्रेक्टेड आउट, सो यू इन दैट पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन यू हैव टू प्लेस योर डिटेक्टर. सो फॉर दिस यू नीड टू लिटिल बिट डू ट्रायल एरर टू फाइंड आउट एट विच पर्टिकुलर एक्सिस दैट डिफ्रेक्टेड बीम इज गोइंग आउट ओके, अकॉर्डिंगली यू प्लेस द डिटेक्टर इन दैट केस ओके. So this is the main thing. Important thing is again this round table is rotating one. Keep in mind. Okay. So we'll see what is the actual difference we are making with that. So all such things we have written it down over here. Okay. Now if you look at the formula which is given by Bragg. Okay. Bragg's formula if you see 2d sine theta equal to n lambda. Let me go through that. Just a minute. Yeah, this formula 2d sine theta equal to n lambda. So in this formula, can you see which are the variable quantities and which are constant? So if I see carefully, then I find out there are two quantities which can be variable. Okay. First is the wavelength. Okay. Second is the angle. Okay. So there are two things you can vary in this formula. D is the interplanar distance. तो वो तो आपको एक पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल के अंदर होगा ही, फिक्स होगा. एन इज द नंबर ऑफ लेयर्स दैट आल्सो कैन बी कंसीडर एज ए कांस्टेंट, वो डिपेंड करता है हर एक लेयर के लिए अलग अलग. बट द वेरिएबल इफ यू सी इट देन इट इज मेनली लेमडा वेवलेंथ एंड द एंगल थीटा. सो हियर इन दिस केस व्हाट वी आर डूइंग इज टू सेटिस्फाई द ब्रेक्स फॉर्मूला फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर सिंगल क्रिस्टल मेथड वी आर वेरिंग ओनली द एंगल. एज आई सेड दिस पर्टिकुलर क्रिस्टल इज ऑन टॉप ऑफ द रोटेटिंग टेबल. So the moment you rotate the table, that means you are making certain angle. So the moment you change the angle, correspondingly you see the different value of lambda or different value of d. क्योंकि lambda आपका fix होगा. Lambda is the wavelength from the X-ray source. So one can obtain the d value with the corresponding theta value which you are going to rotate it. Are you getting the idea? With the help of this theta part, one can get different value of d, provided your lambda is constant. So that is the one thing we are keeping in this single crystal method, that theta is vary. If I generalize, if I summarize this method, then I can say that wavelength is constant, but theta is varied. Okay. But coming to the second method, here is the second method, Laue method we are saying. Okay. Because the scientist Laue has given this concept for this method. So again, you see in this case, again, the same formula, this formula has to verify in all the XRD methods. Okay, as I said, there are three methods. So if all the three, it has to satisfy. So 2d sine theta equal to n lambda, again, you look at. But in this method, this theta we are keeping it constant and lambda only we are going to vary. Now, I must say that you have the proper idea, the basic difference between each method. In first method, single crystal, your theta is changing, lambda is constant. In the Laue's method, lambda is variable, theta is constant. Okay, and you see this is the range of lambda or wavelength 0.2 angstrom to 2 angstrom, your variable wavelength is there. Okay, theta is fixed, keep in mind. So, because of that, again, we are satisfying this 2d sine theta equal to n lambda formula. And with this method, one can get the spot. Okay, so case spots one day we'll see that. Yahan pe likha ye, you see the last line, a plate. Photographic film is used as a detector, and the diffraction pattern consists of a series of spots, and that spots is called as Laue spots. क्योंकि Laue ने find out किया था through this technique. So here is the image. Can you see on the right hand side? Here it is. Okay, ये पूरा setup बनाए. Here is the beam. You are incidenting that. You are keeping the sample over here, and here is the complete detector part जो कि film के form में है. And you see there are different स्पॉट्स, ये जो आपको दिख रहे हैं यहाँ पर, राइट, वो ही लाउए स्पॉट्स है. एंड फॉर ईच लाउए स्पॉट्स वन कैन डिफाइन द एच के एल पैरामीटर जो यहाँ पे रिप्रेजेंटेड है. तो दीज आर ऑल गोइंग टू इन टू द मोर सॉलिड स्टेट फिजिक्स साइड. सो लेट्स नॉट डिस्कस एट दिस मोमेंट बिकॉज दिस इज द not a complete part of the syllabus, but again, you can go into the theory side again in that. So this is one method, but important thing is this one. This method, even though it is there, but it is very rarely used. Okay, the reason is that it can determine the crystal structure. Okay, but look at here the difference. These particular things, I mean, the other methods can use to determine crystal structure, but this one is only used for the crystalline imperfection under the mechanical or the thermal treatment. So basically, if you want to find out some defects in your material, then one can go for this kind of technique. Keep in mind, this technique is there, but people are usually using it only when they want to detect some defects in their material, then they can go for this kind of thing. Then comes to the third one, powder method. Now this powder method is again very simplified one. Okay, let me go through that diagram part first. Here it is. Okay, so in this you see this diagram basically. Okay, at the center we are keeping the sample in the capillary. ये पी करके जो लिखा है, here we are keeping our samples in the powder form. Now important thing is, now this time we can make any angle out of 360 degree. One can make any angle, 0 degree, 50 degree, 60, 70, 80, whatever be the number you want. Okay, that angle you can make it with this. So that is why this has more flexibility compared to any previous two methods. Okay, but otherwise if you look at the feature wise, so the features are almost similar to the single crystal method. Okay, so all such tasks which single crystal method can perform, this powder method also can do the same things. The only thing is there is a wide flexibility in selecting the angle. Okay, so angles ke terms mein ye काफी important है. You can make any degree angle. So that is the main difference again. There is also one device, as I said, electron beam can also be diffracted. So that device name is low energy electron beam diffraction, or LED also is we are saying. But important thing is again, you see this energies of electrons. So as I said, that name itself is suggesting low energy electron beam. So low energy means only 20 to 200 electron volt beam we are only considering for this method. And again, in this we are getting the spots, just like in the Laue case we are seeing the same thing. So let me go through that little bit fast. Here is the thing, the setup, you can check it out. Okay, so this is the sample we are keeping. And this is the screen, ये जो दिख रहा है आपको, this type is the screen. Different grids are there on that, okay? And here is the electron gun. With the help of that, you are emitting the electron beam towards this sample. ये दिख रहा है आपको, towards this sample we are emitting it. So after diffracting from the sample, they are coming to this screen and they are making different spots. So on the right hand side, you see there, these spots are there. So like this pattern you are getting in this. ये और डेप्थ में है, बट आई विल नॉट गो टू दैट, इतना रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है. एंड देन दिस कार्बन फुलरिन नैनो ट्यूब और ये समथिंग. सो लेट मी गो थ्रू इट वेरी क्विकली, विद इन 4 to 5 minutes वी कैन समराइज दिस वन. सो कार्बन फुलरिन बेसिकली यू सी हाउ टू डिफाइन, इट इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ कार्बन. ओके, हैविंग ए लार्ज स्फेरॉइडल मॉलिक्यूल. इंपॉर्टेंट इज अगेन, इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए होलो केज ऑफ 60 और मोर देन 60 नंबर ऑफ एटम्स. ओके, गिवन बाय बकमिंस्टर फुलरिन. This was the scientist who provided this one. Okay, this is structure. So remember, this is a hollow cage of 60 or more than 60 number of atoms. And since it is provided by this Buckminster fullerene, so on the name of that we are knowing as carbon fullerene. Okay, and how to prepare that? It is written here. This fullerenes can be produced, okay, by the action of an arc discharge, electric arc discharge basically, between the carbon electrodes in an inert atmosphere. So अगर आप इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्चार्ज पास आउट करोगे बिटवीन द कार्बन इलेक्ट्रोड एंड दैट टू इन द इनर्ट एटमोस्फेयर, वन कैन सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर लाइक फुलरिंग. वेयर इज द स्ट्रक्चर, लेट मी गो थ्रू दैट. ओके, यहाँ पे लिखा ही है मैंने अलग अलग. इंपॉर्टेंट इज दिस वन, लेट मी चेंज द कलर इट. ओके, एन हैज टू बी ग्रेटर देन 60. It can be 70 also, 76 also, but depending on that, their geometry is going to be changed. अगर 60 तक होगा तो स्फेराइड होगा, but if more than number of 60 atoms are there, then their forms are going to be changed. So you see example, C70 has a rugby-like particular shape geometry. Okay, जैसे जैसे नंबर ऑफ एटम्स आपके बढ़ेंगे कार्बन के, तो उसका जो साइज है वो थोड़ा सा डिफॉर्म होने लगेगा, एंड इट में टेक ए डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर विद दैट ओरिजिनल वन. देन कम टू दिस, या सो हियर एग्जैक्टली यू सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर, ओके, जो कि कार्बन 60 का है, C60, एंड गिवन बाय दिस फुलर, बकमिंस्टर फुलर. सो ऑन द नेम ऑफ दैट वी आर सेइंग इज अ फुल रिंग. क्लियर है? दिस नैनो ट्यूब, कार्बन नैनो ट्यूब इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, सो लेट मी जस्ट कवर इट वेरी वेरी इन वेरी लिमिटेड टाइम. सो वाई वी आर सेइंग, अगेन यू लुक एट कार्बन नैनो ट्यूब, दैट मीन्स इट इज अ ट्यूब मेड अप ऑफ कार्बन, इट्स वेरी क्लियर. बट अगेन नैनो इज देयर, दैट मीन्स द डायमीटर हैज टू बी इन द रेंज ऑफ नैनोमीटर. ओके, सो इट इज अ ट्यूब मेड ऑफ कार्बन हैविंग द डायमीटर इन द नैनो, एंड दीज आर यूनिक्स. ओके, दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यूनिक बिकॉज देयर बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन द एटम्स आर वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, एंड यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बॉन्डिंग. ओके, लेट्स डिस्कस दैट ऑल्सो लिटिल बिट. एंड दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ कार्बन इन ट्यूब्स. ओके, सो बेसिकली देर आर टू कैटेगरीज, वन इज सिंगल वॉल्ड, सेकेंड इज मल्टी वॉल्ड. ओके, यू कैन सी दैट क्लियरली, ये सिंगल वॉल्ड का एग्जाम्पल है, एंड हेयर यू सी द मल्टीपल लेयर्स आर देयर यहाँ से यहाँ तक. सो दैट्स व्हाई दीज आर द मल्टीपल और मल्टी वॉल्ड ऑल्सो पीपल आर सेइंग. हाउ टू प्रिपेयर, सो देर आर डिफरेंट मेथड, सो वी आर नॉट गोइंग इन टू द डेप्थ पार्ट इन ईच मेथड, बट यू मस्ट नो द मेथड नेम एटलीस्ट. ओके, सो दीज आर द फोर मेथड्स वी आर हैविंग, लेजर मेथड, सीवीडी, वॉल मिलिंग, आर्क मेथड. सो बाय दिस वन कैन प्रिपेयर द सीएनटीज प्रॉपर्टीज. दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज, स्ट्रेंथ इज वेरी वेरी हाई, हार्डनेस इज ऑल्सो देयर, एंड ऑफकोर्स थर्मल एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द सीएनटीज. स्ट्रेंथ, अगर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी दैट इमेज और आइडिया, एंड वाई वी आर हैविंग वेरी हाई स्ट्रेंथ, बिकॉज यू सी द एसपी टू बॉन्डिंग. यू पीपल मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट देर आर एसपी बॉन्डिंग, एसपी टू, एसपी थ्री बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन द कार्बन एटम्स. सो दिस एसपी टू बॉन्डिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस स्ट्रक्चर सीएनटीज, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी आर गेटिंग ए वेरी हाई स्ट्रेंथ कंपेयर टू एनी नॉर्मल नैनो मटेरियल. सीएनटीज आर हैविंग वेरी हाई स्ट्रेंथ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस बॉन्डिंग ओनली. एंड यू सी दिस लास्ट पार्ट, स्ट्रेंथ, एंड इंडिविजुअल सीएनटी कैन हैव स्ट्रेंथ अप टू 100 गीगा पास्कल्स. So you see the numbers, these numbers are very, very important. So that much high strength this CNTs may have compared to any normal nano material, up to 100 gigapascal. Or agar main isko is unit mein convert karu psi mein, then you see it is, you can check it out the numbers of course, but I prefer to use this gigapascal unit. Applications, fuel cell mein use karte hain, super capacitors mein use hai because their electrical or thermal properties are very important, very, very, very एक्सिलेंट, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी आर यूजिंग इन इन दिस थिंग. ट्रांजिस्टर्स में है और सम कंपोजिट मटेरियल ऑल्सो वन कैन गो फॉर दैट. एंड यू पीपल मे हैव रिसीव द इनोवेटिव असाइनमेंट ऑन दिस सी एन टीज ऑल्सो, वन और टू पीपल मे हैव गेट दैट चांस. एंड लास्ट थिंग इज, दिस इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस नैनो पार्ट, वे आर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी एंड देयर इम्पोर्टेंस एंड देयर अफेक्ट्स ऑन द एनवायरमेंट. सो दिस टॉपिक आई विल लीव इट फॉर यू पीपल बिकॉज नाउ आई हैव गिव यू द एंटायर आइडिया. So now you can identify, as I said, each technology has their advantages as well as disadvantages also, but it all depends on the end user, how the end user are going to take the benefit from the technology. Okay, agar aap sahi tarike se use karoge, that will give you the advantages. Agar aapne galat tarika use kiya, to wo disadvantage bhi aapko dega, ya wo technology aapko degi. So this I will leave it for you people.